He's reminding me.
Sure, sure. Okay. No. Whichever is easiest for you.
We met with him. It was a great meeting. And he said he will be working with us to create some pressure and work with other countries to create some pressure against the Saleh regime.
وإنه المسألة مسألة وقت وإنه مش من المعقول إنه تعامل المجتمع الدولي والجامعة العربية والمجتمع الدولي مع نظام بشار بتلك الصرامة إنه يحتاج أيضا نظام صالح أن يعامل بنفس الطريقة.
And it's just a matter of time. That the international community is dealing differently with Syria and Libya and different countries, but also not dealing with Saleh the same way. But now it's very. We get into the goals we want. He will actually help us to trying to find a way in how to freeze the assets.
Okay, I asked one. The ambassador of Saudi Arabia spoke today in front of the General Assembly, and I asked him about the GCC agreement. And I said, "Does it?" I said that you personally say it has immunity; it shouldn't have immunity. What does he say? He said, "The Yemeni people have agreed to the GCC agreement. It's not his fault anymore." So what would you say to those who say that the Yemeni people have agreed to the GCC? You see what I mean?
سأل السفير السعودي اليوم أنه اليمنيين وهي ما يشتوش مش موافقين على المبادرة الخارجية لأن فيها موضوع الحسنات. قال لها وكان رد السفير السعودي اليوم أنه المسألة الشعب اليمني وافق بالمبادرة ولذلك هي مش مشكلتهم خلاص ما تعد مشكلتهم على أي
نحن لا نتحدث الآن عن المبادرة نحن نتحدث عن قرار مجلس الأمن رقم 2014.
We're not talking about the GCC initiative anymore. We're talking about the Security Council initiative. We're talking about the 2014 resolution.
قرار مجلس الأمن ألغى مبدأ ألغى اللي هو بند الحصانة والضمانة.
As you know, the Security Council resolution did not mention anything about immunity, and it got rid of
ألغى مبدأ الحصانة والضمانة التي موجودة في المبادرة الخليجية.
إيش كلمة ألغى؟
Delete.
Removed anything that has to do with immunity.
هو نص على إنهم لا حصانة لمرتكبي جرائم القتل.
What it says, the section says that there is no immunity for those who committed crimes.
وتحدث عن ضرورة إجراء تشكيل لجنة تحقيق دولية في جرائم القتل.
And it talks about it's important to have an international investigative commission on the crimes that was committed against them.
واحنا نطالب بتنفيذ قرار مجلس الأمن.
And we actually call in on the implementation of the UN security resolution.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So Monday we'll see you at the council, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I will send you today maybe yesterday. I will send you press release from me.
Very good.
And